guys, it is Tristan with Nerdette's Newsstand, and we actually have an update on the AH and JD situation. Now, this is a really big win, I will tell you right away, but I want to thank the commenter for letting me know about this situation, because I actually didn't see this headline. Now, what we are going to specifically talk about is Johnny being able to get Amber's phone to see about those wonderful photos that she had floating around and showing everyone. Basically, I said it was inflamed zit. And this is pretty interesting. There's one part I want to talk about specifically that kind of goes along the lines of, I originally thought from looking at the pictures that it was likely makeup. Now, this is the photo in question. You can see the giant zit there, and it does look to me originally like makeup. Now, that's what my idea was from the beginning, but it does seem like they think that it was actually more like an editing program, and there was nothing there. Maybe it was a zit, and it was put on top of that, but what we're getting is, yeah, it was a program called Photo 3. So we will get there. Make sure you guys are subscribed, hit like, leave me a comment down below. Let me know what you think of this situation. I also do have another update when it comes to this. I have to do in a separate video. I've been a little bit behind for certain reasons, but I'm back on it now. So it says Ms. Heard's counsel has reportedly used these phony photographs at deposition. Now this is Benjamin Chu, right? And obviously they're going to go over a bunch of the old stuff. Now we've covered it enough. I think we're pretty well versed in this situation. So it says Ms. Heard and her friends then fabricated these photos that she used to obtain an ex parte TRO, a temporary restraining order, which would have been the situation we were talking about in May of 2016. And a $7 million divorce settlement, right, which Ms. Heard falsely testified in London she gave to the ACLU. That is called perjury. That's just not a false testification. That is perjury. More scandalously, to the Children's Hospital of L.A., sick children with cancer. Yep. And she didn't give them the money, but she made sure she said that. And she made sure she boasted that all over the media. And even in court, he added that the LAPD disavowed the photographs, saying that they did not depict what they saw. Now, this was all gone over at the trial in the UK. They actually had them phone in, like Zoom call in, right? Teleconference. And when they did this, they were like, no, there's nothing here. I saw her in clear light. She had no issue. She was crying. Her eyes were a little bit of a mess, but that was all we saw. And I believe that was Melissa Sands they had. And they basically said, okay, we don't need the next lawyer. And that was it with that situation. But of course, the UK judge did not actually listen. So it said the Virginia court ruled Wednesday that Depp team can have an expert look at the phone. We're not talking just the photographs. We are talking the phone and see if they find any evidence of photo tampering. Now, what worries me about that is the program. Well, we'll get there. Chu had argued that earlier images given to Depp's legal team came without any metadata. Well, of course it did. So their expert, Brian Neumeister, could not verify the details. Well, I'm sure it was all any metadata was released or erased. Mr. Neumeister's preliminary investigation shows that a number of the photographs had been run through a photo editing application called Photo 3 that can easily manipulate images such as showing bruises where there was none existed. So, this is what I want to talk about. I actually tried to look up this program. I've never heard of it. This is what worries me with them getting her phone. The only program that I could find Photo 3 was a desktop photo editor, meaning she would have had to, you know, put the photo on her computer, then edit it, and then either put it back on her phone or email it, whatever it was. Meaning that metadata won't show that it was run through this program. Now, there are plenty of other programs out there. This is the one I specifically looked up, and it could be something different. But from the what I'm seeing here is this is a desktop editor. Now, even going through stuff like with Halloween, it is very easy to take your phone, and I was able to, you know, make myself look like a zombie. And you can tell. You can absolutely tell that it's fake, right? So I kind of wanted to dig a little bit deeper and see if this was possible to do. And that's why I originally thought that it was more along the lines of makeup, because makeup can do wonders. Makeup can make a 2 look like a 10 if they know what they're doing, right? We've seen all of the crazy TikToks where people look like different people. So that's what I originally thought it was. So this is an editing tool. I decided to try to edit a photo. Well, I must not know enough, but clearly I wasn't going to use my photo because that was weird. So I used a cover for the newest Dark Knights of Steel, and I was able to do it in about 10 minutes and it wasn't perfect. So if somebody was really trying to to actually do this and do it well, it's very possible. Like, I think we all knew it was possible that makeup was more likely, but somebody that doesn't know these apps besides putting scary eyes on something. And of course I know, like, I use, what's it called? Photo Arts, I think it's called. I'm looking right now as my phone goes off. I apologize. PixArt. That's the one I use for, like, scary eyes or, you know, zombified for Halloween. So I use the same one. Use the one I know, and I was able to put a bruise on Harley Quinn. In 2 minutes. So, yeah, I completely believe this is probably the situation, and I'm hoping that they are able to find the metadata involved. There's got to be a way. There absolutely does. Even if it was on a desktop, it should show the timestamps where she basically put it, say she put it on her drive and downloaded it again, showing that it was on a different device for a certain amount of time. So anyways, the judge, Mr. Judge Nicole, said that the son had proved that there was, that's all, nothing that we need to know. All stuff we already know, but what we are saying here is this. So Ms. Heard, or someone on her behalf. Now what we're looking at is, or let's back up here just a little bit. It does look like in the court filing, Chu argued that the son's own expert concluded that Heard's photograph showed injuries on her face, from December 2015 were manipulated 3 years later. Now they were able to find that it was created on October 6th, 2018, adding any editing on the trial bundle versions would have been after that. So Ms. Heard or someone on her behalf doctored those photographs 3 years later, so that they could come up with testimony in London. Ms. Heard falsely denied it. In short, Your Honor, without forensic imaging, Mr. Neumeister cannot properly assess or verify Ms. Heard's data. I'm sorry, you are hearing my kitten. The court told that she was to appear on James Corden show, right? On the James Corden show, there was absolutely no difference. They're trying to say it was covered up by makeup, but then the makeup lady was like, I didn't see anything. Okay. All right, Amber, we totally believe you. Winky. But she's become a public figure representing DA. Yeah, that's the worst kind of figure I can think of. She literally hijacked a movement that was supposed to be about accountability and never ended up being about accountability. Way to go, Amber. You are not a fraud. Totally not a fraud. So Elaine, who is representing Amber, said She welcomes the opportunity to present her evidence in trial by jury in the court of law next year, while claiming that her and his legal team are attempting to try the case via the media. It is a dirty strategy. Dirty, dirty boy. Jesus. After having been found committed, by Mr. Depp's legal team to present false claims while avoiding accusations of defamation because of judicial immunity. While legal hearings are protected from defamation, they are not protected from leaks in the press, which is exactly Mr. Depp's intention, even though he lost one time, which they didn't have nearly amount of stuff they do now. Just saying. His choice of forum, he is trying to interject out of context and already proven to be false pieces in the UK. Different court system, bitch. Different court system. From his unsuccessful efforts in court to attempt to deceive the public, pretending these issues have not already been fully tried in the UK, you dumb. See you next Tuesday. In the court of choice where he lost. He didn't lose against her. You're a lawyer. You should probably know that. Just saying. Now, in yet another court of law, he is unable to submit his own evidence because he has nothing to prove his claim. No, what? Now? Okay. All right. Sure, Elaine. Here's the thing. This feels like I'm a little nervous. I might be a little nervous, and this video is getting long, so I apologize. But this whole the whole point here is, like, look, everything comes out in the end, right? Whether it is lies or, you know, the stuff I did with DC just yesterday, DC Comics, right? There was a whole hoax that they got death threats over Superman. And I had to apologize for reporting on the thing. And I felt fucking stupid because I naive in some aspects. Well, I'm not naive in this because I've read your court papers, Amber. You're going to a court of jury. Now, I have never been, I went back and forth last time on whether or not to be honest with what I thought in the case. And I said the entire time he was going to lose, right? I even made a video the day before it came out and said, look, just calm down. This doesn't look good, right? I had a lot of people really upset with me for that, telling me, we just need positivity. You're wrong. Well, guess what? This time, I feel extremely optimistic. You've got the jury. And then on top of that, you have really a lot of great evidence this time. I'm optimistic. I do think, as of right now, win after win after win, that Johnny will prevail in this case. We won't know for some time, but it looks really good to me. Honestly, it really looks good. So let me know, of course, what you guys think. I will see you in the next one. Bye-bye.